Hello everyone, I'm going to be reviewing The Many Saints of Newark. It's been a while since this movie has been out, but I watched it on October 2nd and I totally forgot about reviewing it, but I don't care if it's not time to review it, I'm still reviewing this movie. But let's get into it, because I really want to review this movie. Let's go. The Many Saints of Newark is directed by Ellen Taylor, written by David Chase, Lawrence Corner, Connor. Based on characters by David Chase, produced by David Chase, Lawrence Connor, and Nicole Lambert, starring Alessandra Nivola, Leslie Odom Jr., John Berthel, Corey Stoll, Michael Giafone, Billy Magginson, Michelle Del Rossi, John Margro, Ray Liotta, Vera Farmiga. Some cinematography from Karma Morgenthau, edited by Christopher Talefeson, music by Peter Nichelle, production companies from New Line Cinema, HBO Films, Chase Films, distributed by Warner Bros. Pictures, released September 22nd, 2021, in Tribeca, and October 1st, 2021, in the United States. Run for 120 minutes. Budget for this movie is $15 million, and the box office it got $10.3 million, very very little. In 1967, a young Tony Soprano travels with Vicky Maltesani. I don't know people's names. To welcome home Vicky's father, Hollywood Dick Maltesani, and his new Italian bride. Giuseppina Lintani and a soldier in the Mio crime family, which also consists of Johnny Soprano and his brother Junior, Seville Dante, Paulie Walnuts. What kind of name is that? Pussy Pizzeria's father, after a black taxi driver is assaulted by a white police officer's riots break out in Newark. One of Dickie's black associates, Harold McBriar, begins to take part in the riots. Cast for this movie, we have Alessandra Nivola as Dickie, Leslie Odom Jr. as Harold, Vera Farmiga as Lever, John Berthel as Johnny, Corey Stoll as Junior, Ray Liotta as Hollywood Dick, Michelle De Rosa as Giuseppina, I think that's his, I don't know how to say it, Michael Giafone is Tony Soprano, Billy Magginson is Paulie, John McGro is Silvio, Michael Imperioli is Christopher, no, I can't even do a good accent, Samson McCullough is the Pussy character, Pussy, I think that's the name, in development, the origins of what ultimately took shape of The Many Saints of Newark happened when David Chase finished film school, had the idea of making a film about four white persons living around Newark, New Jersey, who joined the National Guard to avoid being drafted to the Vietnam War, only to be sent instead to the 1967 Newark riots. But the films were unproduced following the release of The Sopranos. Chase was suggested for the by Oz creator Tom Fontana to write a film centered on Tony Soprano's father, Giovanni, and Johnny Boy Soprano, set in the 1930s or 1940s. However, the idea eventually fell off due to Chase's lack of interest. Let's get into my thoughts from The Many Saints of Newark. So this was one of my most anticipated movies of the year, and it did live up to the expectations. I think this is a great movie. It's not an awesome film. It's very close, though. It's very close of getting a 4.5, but it's probably after my second viewing, I could probably get 4.5, but The Many Saints of Newark is such a great movie. I really loved my time watching The Many Saints of Newark. The cast is fantastic. To be honest, I've never... I've only watched, like, a few episodes of The Sopranos, and I still got what it meant. I still had a fun time of... This film is a great movie. I really did enjoy my time with this. But yeah, for my score for The Many Saints of Newark, I'm going to be giving it 4 out of 5 stars. Percentage, I'm going to be giving it an 87%. Grade, I'm going to be giving it a B plus. And attitude, I'm going to be giving it an 8.7 out of 10. Thanks for watching my review for the Mini Saints of New York. Hope you enjoyed it. Please subscribe to my channel. It'll be a big help. Thanks for watching. Take care. Peace.